So you'd like to hear a story, huh?
Hmm.
Well, I'm not that great with storytelling. Eugene's a lot better. He always has this great way of starting stories, and he's like, "This is the story of how I died." Oh, he's so silly. But luckily, I'm pretty good at reading books. You know, I read at least 2 or 3 a day. So, well, I only had 2 or 3 back then, but that's not the point. So, lucky I have a very special story here today. This is a story all about my story, the story of Tangled. So, the best stories start where? At once upon a time, of course. And so, this story does as well. Once upon a time, in a land far away, a single drop of sunlight fell to the ground. It grew into a magical golden flower, which possessed healing powers. A vain, selfish old woman named Mother Gothel found the flower and learned to unlock its abilities. For many centuries, she kept it a secret, using a magic to keep herself young and beautiful. One day, the queen of the kingdom fell seriously ill. Desperate for a cure, the townspeople eventually found the legendary flower. Mother Gothel watched in horror as they uprooted it and carried it away. The queen drank a potion made from the flower's blossom and instantly recovered. Soon after, she gave birth to a beautiful girl with golden hair. Furious at losing her special flower, Mother Gothel crept into the nursery late one night when she discovered that the flower's powers had worked into the princess's hair. Well, there was no choice. She snatched the child away. The king and queen were heartbroken. Every year afterwards, on the birthday, the grieving couple released lanterns into the night sky. Mother Gothel raised me inside a soaring tower in a hidden valley. "The outside world is a dangerous place," she would always say. She wanted to make sure that I would not go anywhere, and especially my magical hair. But being confined never dampened my spirit. And just like you guys, I was stuck in a tower for 18 years. But that's okay, I found loads to keep myself busy with. Do you guys know it all? "Rapunzel, let down your hair," she would call every day, and I would have to let my hair down. And as always, she would climb up my hair whenever she wanted to come home to the tower. As usual, I pulled her up. Today was different though. It was the day before my 18th birthday, and I had a special request. I want to travel to see the floating lights. They appear every year on my birthday, and only on my birthday.
"Oh, you mean the stars," Mother Gothel quickly lied.
She insisted that the outside world was a dangerous place and was too scary for a girl like me. "Don't ever ask to leave this tower again," she said. Meanwhile, in another part of the forest, a thief named Flynn Rider came to an abrupt halt. He was traveling with the Stabbington brothers, and they were on the run from the palace. But couldn't the wanted poster make him look a little more handsome? Like he always says, "They just can't get my nose right." Just then, Flynn saw the palace guards on horseback close by. He grabbed the satchel containing the stolen goods and ran, leaving the Stabbington brothers behind. The palace guards on their horses galloped hard after Flynn. The captain of the guard fell from his saddle during the chase, and Flynn hopped onto it. But Maximus, the palace horse, knew exactly what was happening. He fought for the satchel. Maximus bucked, and the satchel flew onto a tree branch across a cliff's edge. Flynn reached the bag first. "Ha ha," he said. Crack. The tree branch splintered, and both of them plummeted to the ground. Will they make it, guys? Of course, they crashed and landed. Flynn grabbed the bag and he ran into the bushes. As he felt his way along a rock face, he came to an opening in a tunnel behind a waterfall.
Scrambling along it, he soon halted in astonishment. What did he see? There, in the center of the hidden valley, stood an enormous tower. It was the perfect hiding place. Flynn climbed to the tower and pulled himself through an open window at the top, and at last he was alone with his satchel, safe from that crazy horse. Clang! I hit him with my pan. He was out cold. Thinking quickly, I stuffed him into a closet and propped a chair against the door. I felt very pleased with myself. Surely in an act of bravery like this would show my mom that I could handle myself, right? Noticing Flynn's satchel, I obviously reached inside and I found this sparkling golden crown. It was so beautiful and something about it seemed so familiar. Oh, Rapunzel, let down your hair! Mother Gothel called, interrupting my thought. I hid the crown before pulling Mother Gothel up to the tower and hoping to impress her with my story about the intruder. But Mother Gothel wouldn't listen, because she never listened. You are not leaving this tower ever, she screamed. I was shocked. Realizing I would never be allowed to leave this tower, I asked her for a special paint for my birthday present, and I knew that it was 3 days' travel. Relieved, Mother Gothel agreed, and she went to fetch them. After Mother Gothel left, I tied him to this chair, using only my hair. I was a tough cookie. So I told him, you see, tomorrow, these lights will appear in the night sky. You will take me to go see them. Then, and only then, will I return your satchel to you. He had to agree. I slid down my hair and slowly touched one foot to the ground. Woohoo! I said, my adventure had begun! Deep in the forest, Mother Gothel ran straight into Maximus, the palace horse. Fearing that palace guards had come for me, she sprinted back to the tower. By the time she reached the tower, she realized the awful truth. Rapunzel was gone, she said, searching the room. She found hidden crown and Flynn's wanted poster. Now she knew who had taken me, and nothing would stop her from getting me back. So, trying to scare me, Flynn took me to a pub called the Snuggly Duckling, and I was like, I do love ducklings. He said it was a real stellar place. Of course he lied. The place was filled with scary men and all of my worst fears. But it wasn't long before the thugs recognized Flynn from his wanted poster. They grabbed him and started fighting over him. I climbed on a table. Put him down, I said, explaining that I needed Flynn to take me to see the floating lights. Haven't any of you ever had a dream? In fact, every one of the thugs had a dream. No one noticed Mother Gothel creep into the window and peer inside. Suddenly, palace guards burst into the pub. They were followed by Maximus and the Stabbingtons, who were now in shackles. Where's Ryder? Asked the captain. The pup thugs had grown fond of me and had already helped me and Flynn escape into a hidden tunnel. But Maximus, he sniffed us out. And soon he led the guards and the Stabbington brothers to the tunnel, continuing the chase. The guards soon caught up with me and Flynn. As soon as we raced out of the tunnel and skidded to a stop at the edge of an enormous cavern, just as Maximus closed in, I threw him my hair. Flynn leaped from the cliff and swung down, grabbing me on my way. When we landed at the bottom of the cavern, we realized that the Stabbingtons were right behind us. The brothers had escaped from the guards and wanted to take the stone and crown back. Suddenly, the dam above us broke, and a giant wave of water swept through the cavern, washing the thugs away, along with Maximus and the guards. We ducked into a cave just in time. The cave entrance collapsed behind us, and water began to pour in. Flynn tried to find a way to escape, but with the rising water, it was dark, and he cut his hand. I'm so sorry, Flynn, I said. Eugene. My real name's Eugene Fitzherbert, he said. Since we're telling secrets, I have magical hair that glows when I sing. Suddenly, I realized I have magical hair that glows when I sing. Then I began singing the special song and woke the magic. And then I dived underwater, and the glow from my hair instantly showed me a hole in the rocks, an escape route. Free at last, we dragged ourselves onto dry land. Her hair glows, Finn said, in disbelief. Why does her hair glow? It doesn't just glow, I said. Again I sang, and my hair healed his hand. I explained about my hair's magic and told him about Mother Gothel and the tower. Finally, Flynn understood. Mother Gothel had tracked me down and waited in the shadows for me to be alone. Now she knew that I hadn't been kidnapped. She had come up with a new plan with the Stabbington brothers. Mother Gothel gave me the satchel and dared me to give it to Flynn. And at once he would leave me, she said. The next morning, Flynn woke with a start. Maximus had found him. The horse grabbed Flynn's boots and started to drag him away. Luckily, I was able to coax Maximus into letting him go. Then I stroked his neck. He's nothing but a big sweetheart, I said fondly. I insisted that Maximus and Flynn cooperate, just for one day. After all, I wanted to see the lights. And did I mention it's my birthday? I added. Finally, Maximus and Flynn agreed. They followed the sound of bells, and this led us to the kingdom. Together with Flynn, Pascal, and Maximus, I stepped through the gates into the bustle of the town. It was so exciting. Flynn brought a flag of the kingdom's emblem, a golden sun, and gave it to me. Then some little girls excitedly offered to braid my hair and add flowers, and it was so beautiful. My attention was caught by a mosaic on a wall. It showed the king and the queen holding a baby girl with green eyes, just like my own. I learned that lanterns were for the birthday of the lost princess. Music filled the square, and Flynn and I joined hands, and we started to dance with the crowd. We were carried away by the music, and the dance, and the pure happiness, and we felt just so happy for being together. As evening fell, Flynn led me to a boat and rowed into the harbor, providing the perfect view for the kingdom. Lanterns began to fill the sky. Then Flynn gave me my own lantern. In return, I offered him the satchel. I'd kept it hidden all day, but I felt confident now, no longer afraid that he would leave me when he had the crown. Just then, Flynn spotted the Stabbington brothers all the way on the shore. He quickly rowed the boat to land. I'll be right back, he told me. Flynn was done with being a thief, so he tossed the satchel to the brothers. But they didn't care. You see, Mother Gothel had told them about me and my magical hair, and they wanted me instead of the crown. Before Flynn could react, the brothers knocked him unconscious. They tied him to a boat and sent him sailing into the harbor. I waited, but Flynn did not return. Instead, the Stabbington brothers came from the shadows. They lied, saying that Flynn had traded me for the crown. I was heartbroken. I ran from the Stabbingtons. Then I heard a scuffle behind some rocks. And then I heard Mother Gothel's voice. Rapunzel? Mother? I found Mother Gothel standing over one of the brothers. She'd knocked them out to save me. You were right, Mother, I said. I was ready to go home. When Flynn's boat bumped into the pier, the palace guards immediately saw the stone and crown. They didn't care that Flynn's hands had been tied to the ship's wheel. They threw him into the prison, but Maximus was watching from nearby. He understood exactly what had been set up and that I was in danger. Somehow he had to help. Inside the prison, Flynn saw the Stabbingtons had been locked in their own cell. Mother Gothel had double-crossed them, and they were furious. Suddenly, the pub thugs arrived. Maximus had fetched them and told them to break Flynn out, and they did. Working together, the thugs launched Flynn over the prison wall right onto Maximus's back. It's really impressive. Now it was time to rescue me. Back in my tower, I looked at the golden sun symbol of the kingdom flag. Then I looked at all of my paintings. I had been painting that sun my whole entire life. Suddenly I realized the shocking truth. I am the lost princess, I told Mother Gothel, grabbing her arm, and I will never let you use my hair again. Mother Gothel yanked away, falling backwards into a mirror that shattered against the floor. Flynn and Maximus raced through the forest. They knew that I was in danger and they needed to react quickly. At the tower, Flynn leaped off. Rapunzel! Rapunzel, let down your hair, he called. Golden hair cascaded to the ground. Relieved, Flynn began to climb. Rapunzel, I thought I'd never see you again, he said and stepped through the window, but it wasn't me waiting for him. It was Mother Gothel. She stabbed him. I was tied in chains, watching in horror as Flynn collapsed. Mother Gothel dragged me to a trap door, but I kept fighting with all of my strength. I will never stop trying to get away from you. But if you let me save him, I will go with you. I promise. Mother Gothel agreed. She knew I would never break a promise. I rushed to Flynn's side and placed my hair over his wound. I can't let you do this, he said. He would rather die than let me heal him. And he wouldn't want me to be imprisoned forever. Flynn touched my cheek. Then he grabbed a shard of glass from the broken mirror and cut off my hair. Instantly it turned brown and lost its healing power. What have you done? Mother Gothel shrieked. She stared into the broken mirror, watching as her image grew older and older. Within moments, hundreds of years aged within her, and she turned to dust. Flynn closed his eyes. His head fell back. He was gone. I began to cry, and a single golden tear fell on Flynn's cheek. Suddenly, the tear began to grow, spreading on Flynn's cheeks and over his entire body, filling the entire room and healing him. His eyes fluttered open. I wrapped him in my arms and I kissed him. It was our first kiss. Flynn and Maximus took me straight to the castle. The king and queen knew immediately who I was and rushed to embrace me. They were overcome with joy that I had finally come back home. I felt my parents' love surrounding me, and as they held me tightly, I was a family together at last. Well, of course the entire kingdom celebrated. Well, I finally returned. Hundreds of glowing lanterns were once again launched into the sky, even more than usually on my birthday. Oh, the light had finally guided me home. Flynn and my dreams came true, along with those of my friends and family. We found our everlasting love. And we lived happily ever after. Hiya guys, thanks so much for listening to Storytime today. Make sure to subscribe so you can see every week's special Storytime. And then also remember to comment your name down below for a special shout out in the next video. See you guys soon!